before starting this bond of love chapter, so the question that was given to you was of diary entry, that you have written a diary for the first time, and what feelings you were having in your heart, and how do you feel while writing the first diary entry. So it is quite, first of all, start with emotion. First of all, the format, day, date and time and all, dear diary, it's really been very confusing for me to write to you. Okay. I have number of friends, but I don't think so I have any friend with whom I can share my feelings. I think you are my true friend. I can tell you anything, and I hope that you will keep all the secrets to you. Moreover, I feel that you, yes, people have more patience than people, and you can listen to me carefully what I want to deliver it to you. So from today onwards, I'm going to share all my feelings, whether they will be happy, sad or surprising with you. But today, for the first time, I'm going to share my feelings, that how I'm feeling. Yes, today I for the first time felt the need to share my feelings with you, because I don't find anybody around me with whom I can share my feelings. Today was really very sad day for me, as I suffered from anything you can write down. Okay, like 4 to 5 lines that I suffered. Don't exaggerate. Okay, don't write too long. So this is how, means for the first time when you are writing diary. So how you are feeling. Okay, so now that's clear. Now you people will be able to do. Okay, fine. So, right. Then afterwards, we were having the chapter Bond of Love. So we have read this chapter Bond of Love also. So we have come to know that the narrator has gone to Mysore in the sugarcane fields for, actually people were driving away. It was not actually hunting. He has gone to Mysore where he has seen in the sugarcane fields, the people were driving away wild pigs. So as they were driving away the wild pigs, by shooting at them, suddenly what happened, what they found, that there was a one bear. Okay, yes, it was separated from his mother. Okay, finally the narrator, what he did, that he took him to his house and presented to his wife. So its presence in the house was quite an overwhelming and enjoyable experience for the wife also. She was very much happy to have this bear in the house. Okay, soon this bear turned out to be the dear one of the family member. And then afterwards, what happened? First of all, how it was feeding? It was being fed upon only on liquid milk with a small bottle. That is but usual, which is always given to that of animals. Okay, so, but now afterwards, the bear was eating everything that is available in house. So what are the things the bear was eating? So we have read, it was eating all the vegetables, fruits, nuts, meat, curry, rice, without condiments and chilies, bread, eggs, chocolate, sweets, pudding, ice cream. And for drinking, he has milk, tea, coffee, lime juice, aerated water, and anything liquid that is available at home. So sometimes the question can be asked in exam. So what are the different things that Bruno would like to eat? So you will include all the list. You will fall short of list, and then you remember, you at this moment of when we are reading, you feel yes, these are the things available. But at that time when you write down in exam, sometimes you don't feel like what to write down. Okay, so just pay attention to each and every detail that is given in the chapter. The bear became very much attached to our two Alsatian dogs and to all the children of the tenants living in our bungalow. So who are tenants? Persons who are living in a house on rent. So he said that this bear, it became attached to the two Alsatian dogs. It means that family was quite pet loving. There were other two Alsatian dogs in the family also, and the bear has developed good relationship with them also, and moreover with the children of the tenants. He was left quite free in his younger days and spent his time in playing, running into the kitchen and going to sleep in our beds. So this is but usual when you have a dog, even at a house. Okay, so this is the usual behavior of the dog. So what the dog, what he's saying, that it was not tied with the rope. It was not leashed. Okay, so it was set free so that it can move, you can say, into the kitchen. It can go to sleep in the beds also. This is also but usual when you have pets, you will allow them to come to your bed and they will sleep there. Have you ever allowing your pets to do that? Yes, all are doing. Okay, so one day an accident befell him. So now, for how long it will be naughty or one? Okay, so let us see, because it has turned out to be naughty. So what happened? One day an accident befell him. So what is the accident? I put down poison barium carbonate. So what was the name of the poison? It was barium carbonate to kill the rats and mice that had got into my library. Bruno entered the library as he often did, and he ate some of the poison. So why the narrator has kept this poison? What is the name of the poison, Sarthak? It is barium carbonate. Sarthak, you stand up from there. Okay. So what was the name of the poison?
Barium carbonate.
Harsimran got now what was the name of the poison? What is the name of the poison? You were not listening. Yes, what was the name of the poison?
Barium carbonate.
Barium carbonate. So why the poison was kept in the library? In order to kill rats and mice. So to kill rats and mice that had got into my library. Bruno entered the library as he often did. He ate some of the poison. Paralysis set in to the extent that he could not stand on his feet. So what was the effect of that poison? What was the effect of that poison? Yes, he was paralyzed. Okay. Yes. Okay. So he was paralyzed. He was not able to move. So see the effect of poison upon animals and what kind of effect it will have, of course, on human beings too. Right? So it was not able to move, but he dragged himself on his stumps to my wife. Stumps means hind legs. Okay. He was moving on the, you can say, four part of the legs. Okay. And it has dragged itself to that, to the kitchen where the narrator's wife was working. I guessed what happened. She immediately come to know what happened. But first of all, she was not able to figure it out what happened to the bear. But later on, when she made a call to the narrator, he immediately came to know. Off I rushed in the car to the vet's resident. Vet means veterinary doctor. So immediately where he has gone to veterinary doctor, ultimately to take the assistance, how to cure it. A case of poisoning, tame bear, barium carbonate, what to do? He was not able to express his, you can say, worry, because he was so much in worry, he was not able to express the complete incident in a sentence. So what he was saying, this is tame bear, and he has, he has gulped down barium carbonate. Okay, the doctor, who was very intelligent, he understood that. Then out came, his medical books and a feverish reference to index began. What poison did you say, sir? Barium carbonate. Ah, yes. Barium salts. Ah, barium carbonate. Symptoms, paralysis, treatment, injections of. Just a minute, sir. I'll bring my syringe and the medicine. So now even the doctor has never encountered this kind of incident. So he said he was also, first of all, he has opened up a book. Okay. So out came his medical books and a feverish reference to index began. Means hurriedly he was looking into that book. Okay, so he was looking at the index where this poison is written and what is the remedy for it? What is the treatment for it? So he said, what did you say? He said, yes, sir, barium carbonate. He said, yes, barium carbonate I got. Then he immediately went into his, that pharmacy where he has kept all the bottles. And ultimately, he has came out with his syringe and the medicine. A dash back to the car. Bruno still floundering about on his stumps. Floundering means he was still struggling on his stumps, but clearly weakening rapidly. Some vomiting, heavy breathing with heavy flanks and gaping mouth. Okay, flanks means this kind of attacks when he was fighting to survive. Okay, and he was not able to take anything except air. So Finally, after getting that injection, he took him back to the car, but he was still, you can say, struggling for his life, sitting on his stumps, not completely able to move. Okay, some vomiting he has also bouted out. Okay, then ultimately heavy breathing, and ultimately mouth was wide open in order to take in air, because it has ultimately affected its respiratory system also. Hold him, everybody. In goes the hypodermic. Bruno squeezes 10 cc of the antidote, enters his system without a drop being wasted. So now doctor came there. He immediately came. Okay, he has came out with that syringe in his hand, and he said, Bruno squeals, because when this syringe, it was injected into the body of the bear, he squeals naturally, he produced it means that the animal will produce a squeaking sound, okay, right, it squeals. So what was given, it was 10 cc, means this is the amount, okay, you know that it is very small amount in that syringe, it is measured in cc of the antidote, it enters into its body, and without even a drop being wasted, not even a single drop was wasted. 10 minutes later, condition unchanged. Even after 10 minutes, the condition did not improve. It was still the same. Then another 10 cc injected. Doctor thought, now we have to give him another 10 cc, because excess of antidote, it will also be fatal for the animal, because it will ultimately have a negative impact on the animal too. Okay, so 30 minutes later, Bruno gets up and has a great feed. I missed one line. 10 minutes later, breathing less free, stertorous. Stertorous means that noisy breathing. Okay, then after 10 minutes of that giving, given 10 cc, finally, the condition of the bear little bit improved. There was not some kind of, you can say, noisy breathing. Okay, and but still the bear was not able to stand properly. 30 minutes later, Bruno gets up and has a great feed. Finally, after 30 minutes, the situation improved and the bear had a feed. He looks at us disdainfully. Disdainfully means with eyes demanding an answer. Okay, like he was cursing them, why you have kept it there, and why I have gulped it down, and why I have been affected so much. What's barium carbonate to a big black bear like me? Bruno is still eating. So finally, it seems like now he's okay. So this barium carbonate did not have any effect upon this animal, but ultimately it affected a lot. Okay, so finally, Bruno was eating. Another time, he found nearly 1 gallon of old engine oil, which I had drained from the sump of Studebaker. The Studebaker is the name of a car, American car, and was keeping as a weapon against the inroads of termites. So this is one incident that how he was behaving, or you can say Bruno was quite mischievous in nature. And this is the second incident that we are going to read. So what happened? It has gulped down what? 1 gallon. Gallon means complete one bottle. Okay. Bottle of old engine oil. Why the narrator has put it in his car? But the name of the car, the brand of the car was Studebaker. It was an American car. Why he has kept? He has kept it against termites. Okay. So that whenever termites will attack, he can have a remedy for it. He promptly drank the lot. But finally, luckily, it had no ill effects whatever. But luckily, what happened, that it had no ill effects upon Bruno. The months rolled on, and Bruno had grown many times the size he was when he came. So now many months passed like this. He was behaving mischievous. He was eating the things. He was gulping down false things. But that was only that, you can say. This incident was quite, you can say, harmful for him when he has eaten. Poison, whose name was barium carbonate. But after that, months passed on, and what happened, that Bruno has came, or it has grown many times its size. Naturally, the bear will grow enormous in size. He had equaled the Alsatians in height, and had even outgrown them. Even means it has reached to the height of the Alsatian dogs. And finally, what happened? It has also grown somewhat bigger than them also. Outgrown means bigger than them also. Okay? Right? Then, but was just as mischievous, just as playful. But this bear, it was quite sweet, it was quite playful, it was quite enjoyable and spending good time with the family members, with the tenants and playing with all. And he was very fond of us all. And bear was also, has developed good relationship with all the family members. Above all, he loved my wife and she loved him too. The greatest bond that has been developed was between his wife as well as Bruno, because she was, why this kind of bond developed? Because it was only she who was responsible to feed him, used to spend most of the time together. They used to play, and ultimately this is the reason why they have developed a good bond with each other. She has changed his name Bruno to Baba, a Hindustani word signifying small boy. So Bruno, she has changed his name to Baba, which means a small boy, because she felt this calling Bruno is little bit, you can say, difficult for her. And in love, just out of love, she was calling him Baba. And at the command, Baba wrestle or Baba box, he vigorously tackled anyone who came forward for a rough and tumble. So when he said Baba wrestle, so anybody who would come in its way, he would tumble it down, okay, throw him down in order to wrestle, like wrestling is being played. Give him a stick when he would say Baba box, and in the same manner he was doing, give him a stick and say Baba hold gun, and he pointed the stick at you. So what happened then? Finally, what happened that then when she would say Baba gun, he was having a small piece of stick and he would hold the stick in this manner, that this is my gun. So these are some of the tricks that has been learned by Baba, and he was playing. So Baba and Bruno are same name of the sloth bear. Ask him, Baba, where's baby? And he immediately produced and cradled affectionately a stump of wood which he had carefully concealed. Concealed means hidden in his narrow, in his straw bed. So the third thing what he used to do is that when they would say, Baba, where's your baby? He would have a small stump, means small piece of stick, which is not so sharp. Okay. And he would like to cradle it in this manner, like a baby in his hands. So these are the different games, different tricks shown by Bruno. Now you come to know what are the different tricks shown by Bruno, that it would play like that. And yes, and on the command, he would, you can say, play these kind of tricks. So what are the different kind of tricks played by Bruno? Sartha, can you tell which are the different type of tricks played by Bruno? Yes. Anybody else? Yeah. No. Okay, Ramneek, you know. Okay, that boy. Yes, your name? Shubham, yes. So what are the tricks that he was playing? Three tricks he was playing. Which are those three tricks? So first one was Baba wrestle. When he would attack, or he would play and tumble down anybody who would come in his way. Second one is Baba gun. And what he would do, he would produce a piece of stick to point at someone. Okay. Right, and on the third one was Baba baby. Okay, so what he was having a stump of wood which he would cradle. Now got? Okay, yes, on that side, Ayan. Yes, what are the different tricks played by Bruno? Sit down, please. What are the three tricks? Yes, Simon, Adam.
Baba Baba box. Baba
Baba baby. Baby. Okay. Gun one and okay. Baba Gun and Baba Baby. Okay. It means when Baba wrestled, they would say what he would do. He would tumble anybody who comes on its way. Right. And Baba Gun. He would have a stick and would produce and would point at a person like that of a gun. And the last one, Baba?
Baby.
Yes, Baba, baby. So what it would do? Yes, right. So fine. Okay. Then my son and I advised my wife and friends advised her too. To give Baba to the zoo at Mysore. He was getting too big to keep at home. So finally what happened? Now, it has grown enormous inside. It has grown very much. Even it has grown the outgrown Alsatian dogs. So what they said, they suggested now Baba is too much large to be accommodated in this house. Okay. So I think even you can say narrator, his son, and moreover, the friends, they have advised her to send it to Mysore in a zoo. As he was getting too big to keep at home, after some weeks of such advice, she at last consented. First of all, though, she nodded, no, this is not at all possible. I can't live without him. So finally, she agreed to this point and... So now, after weeks of such advice, she finally consented hastily and before she could change her mind. Now, the narrator did not even take 1 or 2 days. He thought that before she could change her mind, he immediately arranged the twins and taken Baba to Mysore Zoo. Okay, finally, a letter was written to the curator. Curator means who is in charge of the zoo. It was written to the curator. Did he want a tame bear for his collection? Naturally, they will be happy. They said, yes, of course, we need. The zoo sent a cage from Mysore in a lorry and a distance of 87 miles and Baba was packed off. So, by lorry, okay, cage was sent. Baba was packed in the cage and was sent to Mysore. It means that now the bond, it has snapped between the narrator, wife and Baba. So, in the next lecture, we will see that what will happen, whether they will be happy by being departed from each other, and what will happen to them. Okay. So it means that there existed a bond of love. Okay. Between narrator and between narrator's wife and Bruno. He was no less than a child in the family. Everybody liked him a lot. Okay. So it is for this reason it has become a dear pet in the family also. And now then we will see that what will happen when it was sent to the zoo and how narrator's wife, she reacts.